interested in the way the brain responds to traumatic brain injury and how it changes over time. A traumatic brain injury is when the brain deforms within the skull, and that can occur due to a blow or a strike to the head or another type of accelerating, decelerating force like whiplash. My research is focused on the long-term symptoms of traumatic brain injury. Every persisting symptom depends on neurotransmission occurring in specific discrete areas of the brain. And so whenever there are slight changes in neurotransmission, that can cause differences in behavior that were unlike anything that person did or felt before. If you think of the brain like a circuit board, where each neuron is a circuit, and those circuits kind of go in and out of a black box in the center, where that black box is either information going to the body from the brain or coming from the brain to the body, you can kind of get a better understanding of how the network within the brain and the neurons is set up. And so when we get these things called diffuse axonal injuries, that's basically like breaking that circuit. And you don't have to worry so much in our brain because there's a lot of redundancy. So a lot of times the brain will keep working very similar to the way it did before. But unlike the circuit, our brain is neuroplastic, which means that it can adapt and reconnect. And the problem with diffuse axonal injury is that those connections don't cause the cell to die. They can then reorganize or reconnect and cause problems with the system, sort of like shorts in a circuit. In order to study this in the circuit, we take these tiny microelectrodes and we place them in the brain where we can measure neurotransmission in real time. And so this technology is different than anything else out there because the microelectrodes are tiny, and they're also different because they measure the extracellular fluctuations of those neurotransmitters, and they do it more quickly than any other technology. So we can not only see increases and decreases in the neurotransmitters, but the way that they fluctuate and change during behavior, giving us a more precise understanding of what is wrong after traumatic brain injury.